Now I want to talk quickly about this idea of inheritance. And this isn't going to be like a big fancy explanation of inheritance. I want to define what it is. I don't want to define all the ins and outs of inheritance, at least at this point. So there are situations where we realize we could save ourselves a lot of work. And I've talked about this idea of the fact that good programmers are lazy, right? We want to work really hard one time to do something so we'll never have to do it again. And so when I get to realize, like I used this idea earlier of a video game, where we've got these different objects in the video game, whatever it is. I use the idea of soldiers. Well, if every character in the video game is going to have common attributes like an X and Y coordinate and energy, and it doesn't matter whether it's, a tank or a foot soldier or an airplane, they're all going to have X and Y coordinates and energy, for example, and there's probably other things that they have in common. Well, when I realize there's a situation like that all these objects are going to have in common, even though they're going to have other things that are different, then that tells me that that's probably a good opportunity to use what we call inheritance in the object. And what I can do is go in and create a parent class. And so I can go in and say public class, and what would we call it? I mean, it's the base soldier or the base weapon, the base object. I'll just call it public class. This is going to be the base soldier. Okay, that I'm going to create in my game. Now, soldier might be a tank too. And that's fine. So, public class base soldier. And I'm saying everything in my game is going to have an energy. So, I'll say I want to create a private int that's going to hold the energy. And I'll set that to a default of what do I want it to be? Well, let's say I decide 100. Okay. Private int that's going to be the x coordinate. And I'll set that equal to just 0 to begin with. And a private int for a y coordinate, and I'll set that equal to 0 as well. So starting at 0, 0 with an energy of 100, that's our base soldier. Okay, well, then we have these getters and setters that we've talked about that we need to create a way to be able to get the energy and set the energy. So I'll create a public method called public, it's not going to return anything, but it's going to set the energy. And what do I need to set the energy? Well, I'm going to need an integer that represents E. So when that information is passed to us, then I'm going to set that. So I'll set this energy for this object equal to whatever was passed in as E. Now, by the way, I don't know that I've mentioned it before, but we could come in here and say if the E that was passed in is greater than 100, then, error message. System dot out dot print line, sorry, invalid number, something like that. So that when the calling class, so that we control it, this idea of it's our variable, we can do what we want to with it, and then we could say else set the energy. That can be done inside these methods, right? So it's not just that the only thing we can do is set it. We can do whatever we want to when they call that method. But it's nice that we can put in our own checks to make sure the data is valid. And actually, what we'd probably do is instead of printing out a message, which isn't very helpful, we'd pass back a Boolean that would be true if everything was good and false if there was something bad in the data. If we're looking at how we probably really do it. But anyway, I just wanted to point that out. But for now, I'll just be really simple and say we're going to set the energy to whatever they passed in. And then I guess we could do the error checking on the other side. Probably better to do it on this side. Okay, so public, and this one is going to return something int, and this is going to be our get energy, where they're not going to pass anything in, but they want to know what the energy is, and I can return this object's energy. Okay? And then I'll just do the same thing really quick for the. Well, actually, I'll just leave that for now. because we realize we can create getters and setters for the x and y coordinates as well, right? So this is the base soldier. I'm going to compile and run this. Well, not run it, but I'll compile it. So this is the base soldier. Okay. And then I'll create my other object that's going to be the battle game. Just this is the actual game, so the battle game, just to keep it really simple. And in order to do that, I want to create an instance of the base soldier object. Well, let me do my main method first, public static void main string args, right? Okay, so we've got our battle game now. I'll save this. This is going to sell a million copies with that cool name, battle game. And I could create an instance of the base soldier. Okay, and if I do that, so just call it B. It's a new base soldier. Now notice if I call the set, so B.set. Energy, and I want to set it equal to 50, and then I call that method system.out.println, and I can say get the energy, so b.get energy. So if I do this and then run this game, it's going to print out that object's energy of 50. Okay, not surprising. But this is the part that may be surprising, this idea of inheritance. Well, now I've got this base soldier, but now I want to create a specific soldier. So this is going to be a, you know, I think I'm like everybody else that whenever there's a game, like Call of Duty or something like that, you want to be the sniper, right? So I'm going to create a class that's going to represent the sniper, okay? Now, I'm going to create this class, but I think, you know what? The sniper is just another soldier. It's going to have an energy and an X and a Y coordinate on the board and whatever other stuff we end up putting in this that's common to everything. And so what I'm going to do is inherit from this base soldier object. Now, inheritance, if we use that term in you know, just in life, it means we get something, right? We inherit traits from our parents. We inherit looks and the way we talk and the way we, you know, how tall we are and all that kind of stuff. That comes through inheritance, right? Well, in the world of programming in Java and other languages, when you inherit everything this base soldier has. So if it has an energy, whatever I inherit to is going to have an energy as well. If I have an x-coordinate, it's going to have an x-coordinate. If it's got a y-coordinate, the inheriting object, inherited object will have the y-coordinate as well, and it's going to have set energy and get energy. And I want to show this by saying the keyword to inherit is we extends. This extends the base soldier class. Okay, so when sniper extends the base soldier class, it's going to receive everything that the base soldier had. Let's save this and test it out. So I'm going to come back into my battle game here, and instead of creating an instance of the base soldier, I'm going to create an instance of the sniper. So the sniper, and this is going to be S1, is equal to a new sniper object. Okay. And then I'm going to say s1.setEnergy equal to 75. Okay, that's the energy, and then I'll say s1.get. Well, I got to print it out or something here. I won't be able to see it. So s1.getEnergy, and let's see what happens. Now remember, before I do this, remember what's in the sniper. This is the entire sniper class. There's nothing in there, right? But if I run this battle game, it runs just fine. It sets the energy, and it gets the energy, even though sniper is blank, because sniper has inherited everything from the base soldier. Okay? So that's the idea of inheritance. Now, can I build on that? Sure. Yeah, I can go in. What's specific to a sniper? I don't know what, a range maybe. So I can go in and say, I want a private variable, an integer that represents the range that I can shoot. Okay. And right now the range, if the board's 1,000, let's say the range is equal to, 700. Okay. That's the range. That belongs to the sniper. This will now have the range on top of everything else that it inherited from the base soldier unit. Okay? And then I can create methods. I can say, I'm trying to think of a good method, but I can go in and create other methods that are on top of that are specific to this object that don't apply to other objects. Okay. Well, one other thing I want to talk about really quick is that I had that set energy method. Now notice I can go in and override that method by saying public, and if I look at the object, I don't want to return anything, so public void, and I want to call my own set energy method. Okay, because I want to do something special. When you set the energy in the sniper, I want to say system.out.println. Before I set the energy, I want to say, hey, you just set my energy. I think my example is quickly falling apart here. And then set the energy. Now, can I set the energy? If I say go into this object's energy and set it equal to whatever they just passed in. Oops, I forgot to have them pass in. E. So set this energy equal to E. If I compile this, let's see if I can, so energy instead of this energy. No, it's got private access. And this goes on to a whole other discussion. But the point is, what I was trying to show here is that if I do this instead, then it prints out, hey, you just set my energy, instead of setting the energy. This is called overriding a method. By creating our own method with the same name inside the sniper object, we have overridden the set energy method for the base soldier object. So why do I say that? What the point I want to get across is, yes, we do inherit it, everything from the object, but we have the option to override it if we want to do something different. So if, let's say, 10 out of the methods that apply to, and the information, sorry, 9 out of 10 is what I was wanting to say, of those methods apply, but one doesn't, we can always modify the method that we want to change inside this sniper object. Okay, so that's the idea of inheritance. When we inherit, we get everything that the parent class has plus whatever we add or change. And can we inherit another object from the sniper? Yeah, we can. If there's some sort of special class of sniper, we could inherit one more level. We could say extends the sniper class, and then we get everything that's inside the sniper plus whatever we wanted for this special sniper class. Okay, hopefully that makes sense. Inheritance is really helpful and useful when we get in those situations where we can, where there's a lot of overlap between objects that we're creating. All right, Spencer out.